So thank you very much, Professor Leimeister, first of all, for coming to Bremen, and thank you very much for giving such an excellent keynote speech. My question would be, what makes crowd working different from regular work? So it's a very basic question, but it's still relevant, I think.
There are mainly three things that make crowd work different from other work settings. First of all, it's a very low access to work opportunity. So very often you just have to connect to the web, open the browser, and you're ready to go and work. You don't need to look for work or anything else. The second thing is you can use the web, so anywhere, anytime. And the third thing is you choose. You choose what to do, when to do, and how to do it. And that's basically what makes it interesting to many people.
And what would you say are the most relevant research questions right now? I mean, research questions that are you not working on, but what you think that should be answered?
Well, one of the grand challenges around crowd work is to get a better understanding on how to build good crowd work systems. So how to design work systems that are economically performing well, so that leverage on success in the market, and at the same time allowing for good working conditions and for interesting activities for the people to work with. We don't have that much knowledge about that systematic design principles and how to basically have an engineering view on those socio-technical systems. So that's one of the grand challenges that I see.
And do you think it makes sense to have a conference like the one in Bremen, where lawyers, psychologists, IT people talk together, or do you think that they actually live in different worlds and they shouldn't talk to each other?
Well, they definitely do live in different worlds, but that doesn't mean that they shouldn't be working together. I think that the phenomenon of interest, that the crowd work, by definition, cannot be addressed by one discipline. So if we want to be in a good position to understand what is happening there, to help others understand what is happening there, we need those interdisciplinary collaborations. And on the other hand, it's also a challenge to get to a level of a common and shared understanding of what you're working on, what the others are working on. So interdisciplinary sounds always very nice, but actually it's very hard to work interdisciplinary in a very well-performing way. So that's one of the reasons why I congratulate the University of Bremen of hosting such an event. I wish you all the luck in the world to get to this level where you actually strive as interdisciplinary teams, knowing that that is the actual challenge.
Thank you very much.